The Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat beside the sea. Such great crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat there, while the whole crowd stood on the beach. And he told them many things in parables, saying, "Listen, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seeds fell on the path, and the birds came and ate them up. Other seeds fell on rocky ground where they did not have much soil, and they sprang up quickly since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched, and since they had no root, they withered away. Other seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good soil and brought forth grain, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. Let anyone with ears listen. Hear then the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what is sown in the heart. This is what was sown on the path. As for what was sown on rocky ground, this is the one who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet such a person has no root, but endures only for a while. And when trouble or persecution arises on account of the word, that person immediately falls away. As for what was sown among thorns, this is the one who hears the word. But the cares of the world and the lure of wealth choke the word, and it yields nothing. But as for what was sown on good soil, this is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruits and yields in one case 100-fold, and another 60, and another 30. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
Pray with me. Gracious God, we want to be good soil, and yet sometimes help us. Now, at this hour, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, for you, great God, are our rock and our salvation. Amen. Grace and peace to you from God. I want to be useful. How about you? During our virtual vacation Bible school, I took the participants out back to my garden where I'm trying to grow vegetables. I talked to them about throwing compost in the ground and laying over a coat of fertilized purchased soil and tilling the ground to get the clumpy clay soil to be good soil for planting, and surprisingly, it worked. You should go back there and see. What is more surprising is that there were seeds in the compost that began to grow, and if you take a walk behind the parsonage, you will see tremendous growth in what was once awful, clumpy clay soil. The parable of the sower talks about different types of soil that the sower sows seeds in. On the path, with no soil, in rocky soil, in thorny soil, and then in good soil that produces. The story ends with Jesus telling his disciples exactly what this story means. The seed along the road were people who hear the message of God's word and don't quite get it. The seeds on rocky ground, people who receive the word with joy, and the word endures for just a while and stops thriving. And the seed on thorny ground are people who hear the word and then stuff gets in the way. The things of the world, success, wealth, individualism. But as for what was sown on good soil, this is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields in one case 100-fold, and another 60, and another 30. Sounds simple, right? And I want to be good soil. How about you? Yet, as much as this parable calls preachers to preach about how we are to do better and be better, I'm afraid that this parable isn't really about the soil at all. This parable is about the sower. The one who dares to throw seed all over the place just with the possibility of the seed taking root. Is that how anyone farms or gardens? I don't think so. I believe that part of what we talk about in BBS is mostly about preparing the soil and planting the seed carefully. Yet that's not how God does it. God, the sower, throws the seeds widely and freely without much thought as to where the seeds go. God throws the seed that is the seeds of love, seeds of forgiveness, seeds of grace and mercy. And God, like some good farmers, of course want these seeds to grow. The soil is our heart. And try as we might, sometimes our hearts are barren or rocky or thorny, and seeds, that is the word of God, that is all about loving our neighbor as ourselves, seeking justice and walking humbly, about helping the least and the lost, just don't seem to take root. And that's why God sent Jesus to be an example of how to love, how to include even bent over women and women with an issue of blood and Samaritans, who included everybody. That's why God sent Jesus to be an example of how to love and to do as we promise in our baptisms, to trust God, to proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others, and work for justice and peace. And when we human beings just can't, we remember Jesus gave his life for our sin, gave his life so that we have another chance, another day, another moment, another opportunity for that seed, for that word of God to take root in us. So, when we struggle with coping during this coronavirus as it continues to ravage our country, when we are confounded and confused about the talk of injustice, white supremacy, and what we can do, I say, people of God, keep listening to God's word. Keep reading scripture. Keep exploring and discovering what thus says the Lord. We have God's promise in the 55th chapter of Isaiah, you heard it. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose and succeed in the things from which I. Did you hear that? God promises that the word of God will not return, but will produce. This is what we believe. This is what we trust. Yes, we want to be good soil. Yet we can't be certain that we are always good soil. Try as I might to produce good fruit. Sometimes, well, the birds come and eat that seed. Sometimes, the rocky ground of my heart won't let the word of God rest there. And those thorns, stuff of the world, trying to be successful, trying to make sure I have all the things, well, chokes off that seed. So thanks be to God, people of St. Paul's, this parable is not about us. We are not the subject as much as we like to be the center of attention. At least I know I do anyway. This parable is about God who sows seeds freely and wildly. Seeds of love, seeds sown in our hearts by God that keeps sowing and keeps sowing and keeps sowing until the seed takes root. Until that seed bears fruit and yields. In one case, 100-fold, in another 60, and in another 30. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Please, keep sowing those seeds, Lord. And please, let those seeds of love, forgiveness, and mercy